Pierre. Emerick Aubameyang has handed in a transfer request and is ready to force through a move to Arsenal. According to reports, the Gabon international has long wanted to leave Borussia Dortmund and first told the club he wanted a transfer in December, ahead of a league match against Bayern Munich. The 28-year-old was left out of Dortmund's goalless draw with Wolfsburg, with their coach Peter Sanger explaining that the striker was being punished for missing a team meeting. And now the German publication Bild is reporting that Aubameyang has handed in a transfer request, having effectively isolated himself at the club. As reported by Miguel Delaney, Dortmund need to sell Aubameyang if they are to resign Henrik Mkhitaryan, who is close to leaving Manchester United. Arsenal had also expressed an interest in the Armenian, but it is understood that Dortmund will only allow Aubameyang to leave if they are able to locate a replacement first, and to resign Mkhitaryan, they need to free up the funds for his large salary. Arsenal will likely have to pay around 55 meters for Aubameyang, who has scored 141 goals for Dortmund since moving to Germany from Saint-Étienne 5 years ago. Transfers. Players that are out of contract in 2018. 49 show all transfers. Players that are out of contract in 2018. 149th Alexis Sanchez after a failed deadline day move to Manchester City in the summer. The Chilean forward has refused to sign a contract with the London-based club and will have a host of top European sides after him in January or the summer. Getty Images. 249th Mesut Ozil. The German playmaker's protracted contract negotiations are well documented, and he will have a host of suitors should he fail to resign for the Gunners before the summer. Arsenal FC via Getty Images. 349th Juan Mata. The United playmaker is yet to renew his contract with the club. However, having started 13 games this season, it seems unlikely the Spaniard will be shown the door by Mourinho. AFP, Getty Images. 449th Luke Shaw. Following strong criticism from his own manager and pundits after a series of long-term injuries, the former Saint looks set to leave Old Trafford after 4 seasons that has seen him make only 53 appearances for United. Man UTD via Getty Images. 549th Sander Herrera. Manchester United have a 1-year option they can invoke in the Spaniards' contract should they wish to extend his stay at Old Trafford. Nemanja Matic's arrival has limited the midfielder's opportunities, with the majority of his appearances this season coming from the bench. Man UTD via Getty Images. 649th Jack Wilshere. Having struggled with injuries for years, the Arsenal Academy graduate has played in Arsenal's previous 4 games. Undoubtedly talented, should the midfielder reject a proposed contract extension from the London club, he will have plenty of Premier League sides eager to sign him at the end of the season. Arsenal FC via Getty Images. 749th Emre Can. Heavily linked with a move to Juventus, the former Bayern Munich midfielder has been frustrated by Jurgen Klopp's rotation policy in a congested Liverpool midfield, and with the impending arrival of Naby Keita from Leipzig in the summer, sees his opportunities further diminishing. Liverpool FC via Getty Images. 849th Marouane Fellaini. Struggling for game time in a United midfield consisting of Paul Pogba, Ander Herrera, and Nemanja Matic, the Belgian may be tempted to move in search of first-team opportunities. AFP, Getty Images. 949th Franck Ribéry. The Champions League winner, now 34, has struggled with injury this season, and has understandably looked rusty upon his return to the Bayern starting 11. Bungarts, Getty Images. 1049th Fernandinho. While the midfielder is out of contract next summer, it is believed that Guardiola is keen for the City hierarchy to offer the 32-year-old Brazilian a New contract. Getty Images. 11/49th Staley Blind having made only 13 appearances for Mourinho's side in all competitions this season. The versatile Dutchman has been linked with a move to Barcelona. Getty Images. 12/49th Ashley Young following his conversion to fullback by manager Jose Mourinho. The 32-year-old has scored twice and provided 4 assists with his dangerous delivery from out wide. Teams in the Premier League will be keen to secure the former Aston Villa player's experience next term. Man U TD via Getty Images. 13/49th Giorgio Chiellini at 33. The Italian centre-back is still a world-class player, and with less than a year on his contract, will surely be a bargain for whoever secures his services next summer. Getty Images. 14/49th Zlatan Ibrahimovic, undoubted class. But at 36, whether the Swede represents value for money is another matter, with the striker one of the highest paid players in the Premier League. Getty Images. 15/49th Fernando Torres, the former Liverpool striker, has had to settle for a place on the bench since his return to Atletico Madrid, behind Antoine Griezmann and Kevin Gamero in the pecking order. A move away surely beckons for the 33-year-old. Getty Images. 16/49th Aaron Lennon, former Spurs flyer. Lennon has not been offered a new contract by current club Everton, but will certainly add Premier League know-how to promoted sides looking to avoid relegation next season. Getty Images. 17/49th Arjen Robben, Bayern's other veteran winger, has also had an injury-stricken season in Bavaria, though has still managed to score 3 and assist 4 in all competitions. The Dutchman is certainly still a threat when fully fit. Bungarts, Getty Images. 18/49th Seeker Casillas, having won the Champions League 3 times. Casillas is certainly a high-quality goalkeeper. Could the Spanish veteran be a good signing for a top European club? AFP, Getty Images. 19/49th Santi Cazorla, blighted by serious injuries to his Achilles and having had surgery 9 times in 14 months, the diminutive midfielder will hope to regain his fitness to restart his career. Arsenal FC via Getty Images. 20/49th Bernard, the pacey winger, has enjoyed a 4-year spell in Ukraine with Shakhtar Donetsk, though in not signing a new contract, may have his heart set on playing in one of Europe's top 5 leagues. AFP, Getty Images. 21/49th Mario Balotelli, the enigmatic Italian striker, has reignited his stop-start career in Nice, with 33 goals in 49 appearances for the French side. AFP, Getty Images. 22/49th Hatem Ben Arfa, talent in abundance though lacking work rate. Teams interested in the attacker will hope they can see the player find the form he displayed at OGC Nice, scoring 18 goals and assisting 7 in 2015-16. AFP, Getty Images. 23/49th Ezequiel Lavezzi, the stocky Argentine forward, has been on fire this season in the Chinese Super League, scoring 20 goals and assisting 19 in 27 games. A return to Europe is surely on the cards for the former Napoli man. AFP, Getty Images. 24/49th Joel Robles, displaced from the Everton starting lineup by 30m summer arrival Jordan Pickford. The Spaniard will be eager to guarantee himself more game time should next year. Getty Images. 25/49th Juan Fran, the Atletico Madrid legend, now 32, is under increasing competition from Croatian fullback Sime Vrsaljko and could be tempted by a move before retirement. Getty Images. 26/49th Amin Yunus, the Ajax forward, currently sidelined with a serious knee injury, had an excellent season in 2016-17 and was rewarded with his first Germany cap by the Joachim Löw in June this year. AFP, Getty Images. 27-49 André-Pierre Gignac. The French target man has enjoyed the most prolific spell of his career with Mexican side Tigres UANL, scoring a goal in every two games in all competitions. Proven in Ligue 1 with Marseille, the striker is capable of succeeding in Europe. AFP, Getty Images. 28-49 Johan Caballé capable of dictating games at the top level. The Frenchman could surely be a wild card for a top side in the Premier League next season. Getty Images. 29-49 Joao Moutinho, winner of Ligue 1 with AS Monaco last year. The 31-year-old midfielder is into the final year of his contract. AFP, Getty Images. 30-49 Leon Goretzka, the box-to-box midfielder, has had an excellent start to the season, scoring 4 goals from central midfield for Schalke. The German international has been linked with moves to top European sides Barcelona and Juventus. Bungarts, Getty Images. 31-49 Carlos Vela, the Mexican wideman, has found goals hard to come by this season, scoring just once this season for Real Sociedad. AFP, Getty Images. 32-49 Yaya Toure, after years of speculation that Toure would leave Manchester City, the Ivorian's time at City finally seems to coming to an end. Getty Images. 33-49 Stefan de Vrij, Liverpool have been linked to the Netherlands international in recent weeks as Jurgen Klopp seeks to add quality to his defense. Getty Images. 34-49 Neven Subotic, the Bundesliga winner, has made only 4 appearances this season, often failing to even make the bench for Dortmund. Getty Images. 35-49 Max Meyer, the 22-year-old playmaker Meyer has been consistently linked with Liverpool, Tottenham and Barcelona and has so far refused any contract offers made by Schalke. Bungarts, Getty Images. 36-49 Dani Garcia, the Spanish midfielder, has been a mainstay for SD Eber over the past 3 seasons, offering a goal threat from midfield with his long-distance shooting and set-piece ability. Garcia could prove a shrewd acquisition. Getty Images. 37-49 Achraf Hakimi, the Moroccan fullback, has deputized well for Dani Carvajal in La Liga this season, and has shown glimpses of his potential at the Bernabeu. AFP, Getty Images. 38-49 Stefan Lichtsteiner, disappointing performances for the Bianconeri this season, and added competition from Mattia Deciglio have led to rumors that the Swiss defender could be set to leave Turin in January. Getty Images. 39-49 Diego Reyes, the 25-year-old defender, has guided FC Porto to the top of the Primera Liga, conceding only 6 goals in the process. AFP, Getty Images. 40-49 Cenk Uzun, still only 20. The Turkish forward has seen his career stall since moving to Spain from Manchester City. Should the striker fail to sign a new contract with Villarreal, a move back to the Eredivisie could prove fruitful for a striker with vast potential. Getty Images. 41-49 Rafinha, the experienced Brazilian right-back, is entering the last year of his contract with Bayern Munich, capable of deputizing at the top level, and with invaluable experience in the Champions League. The 32-year-old could provide excellent cover for an elite European side next season. Bungarts, Getty Images. 42-49 Ivan Marcano, the Porto centre-back, also capable of playing left-back, has been the subject of interest from Everton following a number of impressive displays for the Iberian club. AFP, Getty Images. 43-49 Joao Miranda, former Atletico Madrid star Miranda, has started all but 1 league game for Inter Milan this term, helping his side keep 8 clean sheets so far. Should he fail to renew his contract with the Nerazzurri, he will be a top acquisition for any side. Getty Images. 44-49th KEPA Arrizabalaga. The 23-year-old goalkeeper is yet to sign a new deal with Athletic Bilbao and is rumored to be close to agreeing a move to Real Madrid for 20 meters. Getty Images. 45-49th Kwadwo Asamoah. The five-time Serie A winner is capable of playing in a variety of positions and would certainly be a valuable squad player for top sides in Europe. AFP, Getty Images. 46-49th Mark Uth. The 26-year-old striker has been in excellent form for Hoffenheim this season, scoring 12 goals in all competitions. Bungarts, Getty Images. 47-49th Pedro Leon. Injured since the summer, the experienced right winger would be a gamble with such little game time in the past year. If he can prove his fitness, the winger is capable of creating chances from wide areas, with 6 assists last season in La Liga. AFP, Getty Images. 48-49th Sergio Canales. The Spanish playmaker is yet to agree a new contract and has proven, when fit, that he is capable of playing at the top level. AFP, Getty Images. 49-49th Zlatko Junizovic. The Werder Bremen creative midfielder has assisted 49 in 182 appearances, scoring 20 goals in the process. Bungarts, Getty Images. Malcolm move proves difficult. In other Arsenal news, Bordeaux have attempted to pour cold water on suggestion star man Malcolm could be an Arsenal player before the end of the month. Malcolm in action for Bordeaux this season. Getty, the Brazilian is one of the Gunners' top targets to replace Alexis Sanchez but might not be on the move after all. Things are clear with his agents. He has not been extended and secured this summer to give him away this winter. Stefan Martin told L'Équipe, "We never had a discussion with Arsenal. From our point of view, it's wind. They can always try, but they will have a hard time taking him from us." Quote, Sanchez deal edges closer. Alexis Sanchez transfer to Manchester United was 75% completed as of Monday night despite late interest from Chelsea as Manchester City pulled out of the race for the Arsenal forward once and for all. Alexis Sanchez's future is likely to be resolved in the coming hours. Getty, United are willing to pay the 35 meters asking price, but Arsenal now want 30 meters plus Henrik Mkhitaryan. And that's where the clubs are differing on the deal. The Armenian would prefer a move back to Borussia Dortmund, and the wages on offer at the Emirates are some way off his demands. Mkhitaryan was left out of United's squad on Monday, with Mourinho admitting he didn't select him because of the speculation around his future. Arsenal wanted Anthony Martial as part of the deal, but it was rejected out of hand. United are willing to pay Sanchez the 400,000 Weakes is asking for in a deal which would cost the club 100 meters in total for the 29-year-old, who has 6 months remaining on his contract. This is 60,000 week more than what Manchester City were offering. Although Pep Guardiola's side were only willing to pay 20 meters and backed out of the deal once they realized how much it would cost them in total. Chelsea made a late swoop on Monday night as the club contacted the Chilean representatives to ask about his demands and are willing to capitalize on and break down between the three parties. They are hoping the lure of remaining in London will be enough to persuade Sanchez. Mignolet considering future. Simon Mignolet, the Liverpool goalkeeper, has admitted that he is considering his future at the club after seeing Loris Karius move ahead of him in the pecking order. Simon Mignolet was dropped by Jurgen Klopp for Sunday's meeting with Manchester City. Getty, Mignolet was dropped to the bench by Jurgen Klopp ahead of Sunday's 4-3 win over Premier League leaders Manchester City, with Karius starting in goal. Klopp confirmed before the kick-off that Karius should now be considered Liverpool's first choice keeper, and he later defended him after his performance against City was criticized, insisting he will stay in goal. Mignolet understands and respects Klopp's decision and, while speaking to Belgian outlet Sporza, denied reports of a rift between himself and Klopp. West Ham want to keep Carroll. West Ham have no interest in allowing Andy Carroll to leave the club on loan during the transfer window. Assistant manager Alan Irvine has said, Chelsea manager Antonio Conte is keen to bolster his attacking options after seeing his side go 3 successive matches without scoring a goal. Chelsea want to sign Carroll on loan. West Ham United FC. But Irvine believes loaning Carroll, who has scored just twice during another injury-hit campaign, is out of the question. I certainly hope Andy will be a player here at the end of the month. Irvine said, I don't think we have had any offers in terms of taking him on loan. And I don't think the club would entertain him going out on loan. That does not help us, and we need as much help as we can get between now and the end of the season. So I don't know why that would be attractive to the club if it was to come up. There has been a lot of talk about it, but not necessarily anybody doing anything about it. Quote, news and rumors from around the web. Manchester City's decision to end their interest in Alexis Sanchez leaves Manchester United favorites to sign the one-away Arsenal forward on a $350,000-a-week deal. The Daily Mail reports, the Chile international, 29, is said to have wanted too high a salary for City, who pulled out of the race on Monday. City's withdrawal does not leave him a shoe-in for United. However, as Chelsea have discussed his terms and are yet to rule out a bid. According to the paper, as a sweetener, Jose Mourinho may give Sanchez United's fabled number 7 shirt previously worn by greats including David Beckham, Cristiano Ronaldo, Eric Cantona and George Best. Sanchez's impending departure has seen the Gunners open up talks with Borussia Dortmund over a transfer for Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. According to the Daily Mirror, Arsenal's new head of recruitment, Sven Mislintat, knows the 28-year-old Gabon forward from his time at the Bundesliga club and has recommended him to Emirates top brass. The newspaper reports, Dortmund are reported to be after 60 million for Aubameyang. However, which is likely to lead to delays while a deal is thrashed out. The Gunners' fund could be boosted by the 20 million sale of Theo Walcott to Everton, which could happen this week. The Daily Mirror says, the Toffees are said to be intent on securing the services of the 28-year-old forward, who may be inclined to move to Goodison Park with the promise of more play. The England player, who joined Arsenal from Southampton in 2006, has only made 6 Premier League appearances this season. Across London, Chelsea's plot to grab Andy Carroll to boost their attacking options is to be met with strong resistance by West Ham. The Sun reports, the Blues are said to be planning to offer the forward an opportunity to move to Stamford Bridge. On loan, Carroll has struggled to be part of Hammers boss David Moyes' plans while recovering from an ankle injury. However, assistant manager Alan Irvine said the 29-year-old remains part of their strategy. According to the Evening Standard, West Ham are only open to a permanent deal. Swansea are in talks with Atletico Madrid over potential transfers for France striker Kevin Gamero and Argentina midfielder Nicolas Guidon. Wales Online report, new boss Carlos Carvalhal arrived tasked with keeping the club in the Premier League. And beefing up forward reinforcements is reported to be a priority. West Ham duo Di Fersacco and Andre Ayew are reported to have been targets when the transfer season got underway, although the interest is said to have waned.